Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making chicken and cheese bow ties. And the bow ties are pasta. You can use any kind of pasta that you like. If you have elbow macaroni or whatever you have on hand or whatever you want to buy in the place of the bow ties will be fine. But I started by calling it chicken and cheese, so let me talk about the chicken for a moment. You need some cooked chicken, and you can use canned chicken that is drained if you'd like to. You can get a rotisserie chicken from your deli and just pick all the meat off of it, and I would discard the fat and skin and anything that I wouldn't find desirable in a dish. You can actually go to the deli and have them slice you off about a half inch worth of chicken and then cut that into cubes. But you need about 2 1/4 cups or 2 1/2 cups, let's say. So I have been working on my chicken, and what I like to do mainly in preparing cooked chicken to give it the best flavor and texture is to put it in a crock pot or a slow cooker. And I just dump it in there, and these are chicken breasts that are boneless, skinless. They may have a little bit of fat on them. Don't worry about that. I salt them, and then I let them, I put the lid on, turn it on high, and let them go for about 4 hours. And when I come back, I have these nice pieces of breast meat. And I have saved one to show you what I do to prepare it like this chicken. I've got 2 cups there, and I need another half cup. So I was getting about a half cup or maybe 3/4 cup from each one of these, but this is kind of on the small side. I just kind of cut with a chef's knife in about 3 places, but then I like more of a pulled look. So I separate it with my fingers instead of chopping it. When you have those cubes, to me that just kind of looks prefabricated and doesn't really look as good as this look that you can get with your chicken. So I'll put that in my little half cup. So we'll say we have 2 1/2 cups of chicken, and we'll come back for that in just a minute. And in the meantime, I have a damp towel here that has a little bit of detergent in one corner. So I'm gonna kind of clean off my hands and use the other corner to dry. Next, I'm going to make a sauce that is my cheese sauce. And I'm going to do it in a double boiler. So I have the top of my double boiler here, and I have some water boiling over there. And hopefully it'll be ready when I get this put together. I'm going to take cubed Velveeta cheese. Now this is the 2% milk variety, so it's a little lower in fat. So that's kind of nice. I like to do that, but you can use just any kind of Velveeta cheese, or you can change the cheese if you like. A lot of people complain about Velveeta, and I think they think it's unhealthy, or they just prefer some other kind of cheese. I particularly like it because of its melting capability, but if you want to put cheddar cheese in, Swiss cheese, whatever you like, any flavor of cheese that you like, it's fine with me. Don't worry about me. Velveeta is what we're putting here, and it's 1 pound. This is a 2 pound box. I cut the inside part right down the middle, then I cubed it, and that's just to make it easier to melt. Okay, then we're going to have, place this here, we're going to have some sour cream, and this happens to be the full fat variety. That's just what I had. If I'd had the fat free variety, that's what I would have used. Sometimes I buy full fat items for a particular purpose and they don't get used for that, and I don't want them to go old. So this is fairly fresh, but I didn't have the other, and I need 8 ounces. This happens to be a 16 ounce carton, so I'm just going to estimate what half of it would be. So we have our sour cream mixed in with our Velveeta cheese. It's going to give it a nice tartness. That's about half of it. And then some milk. I'm using skim milk. You can use any kind of milk. 1/2 cup, and that goes in. So now I'm going to take this over to my double boiler. If it hasn't boiled yet, that's okay. It will boil, and I just want to get this melted. So once it's melted, I'm going to come back and we'll continue with our chicken and anything else that we need. When your cheese cubes melt, you're ready to continue with adding some other things in. And you don't have to use a double boiler like this. You can just use a regular deep skillet or saucepan, enough that will hold a lot of items that are going in. I hope this will hold everything I have. If not, we'll transfer it to something different. But I have my chicken that I mentioned already, the 2 1/2 cups. So I'm just placing that in the melted cheese and sour cream and milk. And that's quite a lot right there. I cooked my bow tie pasta according to package directions, and I added 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Now this is a 12 ounce container of bow tie pasta, and I needed 8 ounces, so I needed 2/3 of it. So I've gone quite a distance down in here to get the amount of pasta I need. And if you're using a different kind, just use 8 ounces. Now we'll reach in here, and I think I can use a longer spoon than that. So I'm going to try to stir this around. Basically, I just need to heat it at this point. And I kind of have this brimming, so you may choose to use something a little different. But all you need to do is make sure you get everything coated with that nice cheese and sour cream sauce. It's going to taste wonderful. And I'll be back in a minute to serve it up in a dish. Chicken and cheese bow ties are done. And I'm going to turn this off and then bring all of this over. It's going to be drippy on the bottom, so I have a cloth here. Sort of prop it on that while I'm getting this ready. See, it's all steamy and hot. Looks wonderful. So here we go into a nice serving bowl. And this can be your main course because it has your chicken, it has the pasta, and then it has the accompanying flavorful sauce. So I'm trying to get all of it out, and that's pretty much it. So we'll let that go. And this is our chicken and cheese bow ties. I hope you enjoy this recipe. Here's our completed chicken and cheese bow tie recipe. And I want to show you what a serving might look like. So I'm just dipping down with a nice serving spoon and getting some of all of those flavors. Didn't get much that time. Try it again. Actually, this spoon shape is not really great for the bow ties. So you can figure out something that works for the kind of pasta you've chosen, because you want to get some of the pasta, some of the chicken, and some of the sauce. I want to get more of that chicken on there. And that looks really good. That's what a serving looks like. I'm going to leave my serving spoon behind and come over here to my place setting. And I'm serving this with cream cheese and chive biscuits. I'm also serving this with a green salad and a glass of iced tea. So let me just take a bite for you and let you see what it's like. It's pretty obvious what it's like, but here's some chicken, and here's a little bit of pasta. Don't want to take a whole one of those. There's a nice bite. It's creamy. I think you'll love that sauce. Having that sour cream in there makes all the difference in the world. You could do the same thing with just Velveeta cheese and milk, and you'd have a nice creamy cheese sauce. But when you put that 8 ounces worth of sour cream in it, it really makes the difference. I think you'll love it.